IT jobs form a leading employment sector with generous returns to its employees. Now, this sector is booming, with the revenue generated observed to have grown 8% in the year 2019 alone, reaching a massive $167 billion. Hence, we have put together a list of the top 10 highest paying IT jobs for the year 2020. But before we begin, kindly subscribe to us and don't forget to hit that bell icon to never miss an update from the EduRekha YouTube channel. Now remember, this list takes in multiple factors apart from just the annual average salary to close in ranks, namely the salary range, both top and bottom, the number of employees currently in said job, and the number of job openings. So keeping that in mind, let's get started. At number 10, we have the full-stack developer. The full-stack developer has the ability to work on all aspects of application development. So it requires the knowledge of both front-end and back-end development, as well as database networking and system infrastructure. Some of the skills required for a full-stack developer are the basics of web development, database technologies, API development, and along with it, you also need to have the knowledge of various technologies such as Angular, React.js, MongoDB, and Node.js. Luckily for you, the full-stack developers program from EduRekha covers all of these technologies in ample detail. What more? Top-notch companies such as Wipro, IBM, Cognizant, Tata, and Infosys are hiring full-stack developers with an average pay of $112,000 and nearly 9 lakhs in India. At number 9, we have the software architect. The software architect interacts with clients as well as developers to optimize development processes by making various design choices. Now, this requires a keen understanding of software architecture, and some of the skills required as a software architect are the technical knowledge, good analytical and programming skills, as well as communication and management skills. Companies like Nvidia, Bosch, Siemens, and Nokia are coughing up an average of $139,000 in the US and 25 lakh rupees in India for this profile. At number 8, we have a blockchain engineer. Now, this professional develops and implements digital solutions using the blockchain technology. So basically, these engineers construct and deploy the system architecture, decentralized applications, while also collaborating with colleagues to guarantee streamlined implementation of applications. Hence, the salary offered to a blockchain techie with just 5 years of experience is almost at par with that of a general manager in a bank with 3 decades of experience. Some of the skills required for a blockchain engineer are a thorough knowledge of various technologies that are used in Bitcoin, Ripple, and Ethereum, as well as analytical skills and attention to detail. Now, companies like Bosch, Accenture, and Standard Chartered are a few names you would associate with the recruitment of blockchain engineers, offering an average pay of $157,000 in the US and 10 lakhs in India. At number 7, we have the IT program manager. Now, these managers are responsible for handling all aspects of a technical project's journey for a company. This means they need to initiate the program, track its progress, and provide support if issues arise. They typically coordinate efforts amongst their own employees and outside vendors, set schedules and timelines for both employees and the project, and ensure deadlines are met. While no company in this day and age can function without an IT program manager, here are a few that are recruiting heavily for this job profile. We have Amazon, Accenture, Boeing, Google, and Standard Chartered. The average pay for an IT program manager is $136,000 in the US and 16 lakh INR in India. At number 6, we have the senior DevOps engineer. The senior DevOps engineer handles the deployment and network operations of an organization by overseeing the code releases. Now, this involves handling the deployment model, managing the resources for provisioning, monitoring the release performances, etc. Some of the skills required for this job profile are good coding and scripting skills, as well as knowledge of DevOps tools such as Jenkins, Docker, Git, Kubernetes, and Puppet. You also need to have a knowledge of Linux or US system administration, as it is a key skill. The average pay for a DevOps engineer is $114,000 in the US and 21 lakhs in India. But it is so high on our list due to the growing number of job openings in the scene. Companies which are hiring senior DevOps engineers are SAP, McAfee, and Oracle. What you need here is a structured approach towards learning DevOps, and EduRekha's DevOps training is designed in a way to help you become a certified practitioner with complete hands-on throughout the DevOps lifecycle. At number 5, we have Data Scientist. Now, the Data Scientist analyzes complex data to find common trends and patterns that eventually help in making more informed business decisions. This involves collecting data from various sources, cleaning it to ensure accuracy, and then using various data models and algorithms to analyze the data. After that, the data scientist may use data visualization techniques to convey the findings to company officials. Now, some of the skills required for a data scientist are knowledge of statistical analysis, knowledge of programming languages such as Python, R, SQL, etc., as well as good data intuition and strong business acumen. The average pay for a data scientist is $133,000 and the corresponding Indian salary is nearly 18 lakhs a year. And this is offered by various tech giants that run the IT industry such as Visa, Netflix, Google and Mu Sigma. At number 4, we have the Network Security Engineer. Now, a network or a data security engineer plans and implements the security measures necessary to protect an organization's networks and systems from cyber attacks and security breaches. They typically investigate any security violations or potential breaches that arise. They conduct penetration testing, develop security standards for a company, and use firewalls and data encryption to protect sensitive information. The knowledge of computer networks, operating systems, monitoring and encryption tools, as well as information about risk management factors are a few prerequisite skills for an average salary of $143,000 and a corresponding 26 lakhs in India. Companies like FireEye, HackerOne, IBM and Cisco are listed in the top 150 companies for network and data security. At number 3, we have the Cloud Architect. Now, this professional manages the cloud computing strategy of an organization, which includes cloud management, application design, cloud architecture, and deployment models. Some of the skills required for a cloud architect are the knowledge of an operating system such as Linux, an understanding of cloud computing services, cloud security, etc. EduRekha provides a variety of programs to build your basics as well as refine and add to your experience in cloud computing. As a cloud professional, you bring home a whopping $154,000 in the US and 15.3 lakhs in India from companies such as Google, Amazon, EY, and HTC. At number 2, we have the Enterprise Architect. Now, an Enterprise Architect develops the plans and workflows for deploying and maintaining servers, software, and other IT assets. He or she is principally focused on ensuring that the business aims of an organization are supported by its IT strategy. Skills like the understanding of business model, process knowledge, knowledge of foundational IT architectures and technologies, and experience in project management are expected off of an enterprise architect. Also, leadership and communication skills are an added bonus and are very important for an enterprise architect. These employees handle much of the interaction between a business side of a company and its IT department. Hence, taking home a handsome $151,000 a year and on an average of 25 lakhs in India. From multinational companies such as Amazon, VMware, HSBC, and Mindtree. At number 1, we have the Artificial Intelligence Engineer. Now, the AI engineer handles the development and management of an artificial intelligence solution of an organization. This involves creating solutions for the client as well as the system architecture based off of AI frameworks. Some of the skills required for an AI engineer are programming languages with a rich library of statistical packages, such as Python and R. Along with this, you need technologies in the domain of AI such as machine learning, deep learning, statistical learning, and neural networks. At EduRekha, there are a variety of training programs which are curated to be the stepping stone to your AI or ML career. Another important thing to note here is that in order to become an AI engineer, one not only needs to be good at programming but also good at software development techniques and practices. So I'm talking about modularity, object-oriented programming, classes, design patterns with a strong foundation in statistics and mathematics is appreciated. And this hard work will definitely pay off when you receive your first big fat paycheck from brilliant paymasters such as Facebook, Google, Procter & Gamble, and IBM. of about $175,000 on an average in the US and 20 lakhs on an average in India. Now, having said that, there are also few other jobs that we just couldn't end our list without mentioning. We are talking about profiles such as data warehouse architect, database administrator, and job roles that fall under robotic process automation. Now, these job profiles also pay pretty handsomely, but they just didn't make the cut this year. But with the increasing demand of these professionals by more and more brilliant paymasters, we are pretty sure they'd land a spot on our list the next time. With that, I come to the end of my list. If you think we've missed out on a few job profiles or you have suggestions to improve our list, please do share them with us in the comment section below. And we would be glad to hear from you. With this, I close the session. My name is Upasana. Thank you and have a great day.
I hope you have enjoyed listening to this video. Please be kind enough to like it, and you can comment any of your doubts and queries, and we will reply them at the earliest. Do look out for more videos in our playlist and subscribe to EduRekha channel to learn more. Happy learning!